In this video, I'm going to show you how to do this H pattern on the front and back faces on a 3x3 Rubik's Cube. Check out my other video showing you how to solve a 2x2 Rubik's Cube, a 3x3, a 4x4, and even a 5x5. So to do this pattern, you do need to start with a solved Rubik's Cube, so you need to know how to solve a Rubik's Cube or have a solved Rubik's Cube, and you need to know how to use algorithms on a Rubik's Cube too. If you don't already know how to use algorithms, then check out my 3x3 tutorial on how to solve a Rubik's Cube. So as well as a normal algorithm letters, F, B, L, R, etc., sometimes you do need to use a few extra letters for these middle rows. For example, this middle row here, we will give the letter M for middle, and that would be MI. For this row here, we give the letter E, and the E is for equator, and that way it would be E, that way it would be EI, inverse. And for this one here, this side one, we give the letter S, and that would be S, and that would be SI. Now, it's not very often we need to use these letters, but for these first few patterns that I'm going to show you, we will do. So to do this pattern, we just need to use a very simple algorithm, and that algorithm is M2, U2, M2, U2. So let's do that then. We go M2, U2. M2, U2. And that gives us the H on the front and the H on the back. Now to undo this pattern, you want the H on the front face here and just repeat the same algorithm. So we go M2, U2. M2, U2. And there we're back to a solved Rubik's Cube. Hope it helped, guys, and thanks for watching. For more Rubik's Cube patterns, check out my other videos. And also, if you know of any other Rubik's Cube patterns that you'd like me to make a video of, then feel free to leave a comment in the comment section with the algorithm, and maybe I'll make a video of that in the future. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye.